May 2nd, 9 months in the past. this experiment, I have to keep these breaks towards in between pieces relatively brief, as is science, you know. So the next piece I'd like to perform is called Reflections on the Reflections on the Mississippi by Michael Daugherty. He wrote this piece in memory of his late father. It is in four movements: Mist, Fury, Prayer, and Steamboat. Each movement is meant to evoke different visions, all concerning the Mississippi River. The first movement, the cool mists over the murky water. The second movement, the Great Mississippi Flood, 1927. The third movement, overlooking a stunning panorama from a distant vista as sunset submits to starry night, and then adventures out of Mark Twain's famous novel, Life on the Mississippi. Reflections on the Mississippi.
Thank you.
Open up this next half of the program with a piece by James Barnes, originally written for wind band. He wrote it because he admired the works of Percy Grainger so much, but they were just so inaccessible to younger or inexperienced groups. So he wrote this piece with a lot of that same tasty Grainger flavor. Say that 10 times fast. This is a piece he later arranged for high tuba or euphonium for virtuoso tuba soloist Pat Sheridan. This is Yorkshire Ballad. Thank you. fake out. all right, the last piece on the piano accompanied portion of this recital is Plog's Tuba Sonata. It's a low-key staple in the tuba repertoire. A lot of people play his concerto, and I've heard a lot of people say, oh, I like his sonata. I keep meaning to play it. Play it. It's a great piece of music. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
my program. Now I'd like to invite the Legato Pesante Tuba Quartet to come up and be my pick group. And while they do that, I'll take this as an opportunity to dish out some thank yous that I wrote down because I don't trust myself to remember much. Let's see. First, I'd like to thank the administration. Despite this mess we find ourselves in on a national level, they were the ones that put in the work, fought for us, facilitated, and made sure that we are able to do this, which is awesome. These people include, and are not limited to, Larry Allen Smith, Glenn Ansett, Leonard Breton, and more. But I can't go on because limited time. Let's see. Thank you to the one, the only, Scott Mendoker, for being a terrific and understanding teacher and mentor who has supported me both in performance and life, especially this semester. Thank you to James Jackson, whose coaching has helped excavate the power and style you're about to hear out of the Legato Pesante Tuba Quartet. Thank you to the ghosts of teachers past, John Bottomley, Justin Benavidez, Craig Sutherland. Without them behind me, I wouldn't have made it to where I stand today. Thanks. Thank you to the wonderful, talented accompanist, Elisabeth Tomczyk. Where did she work? Yeah. Thanks! I look forward to at least one more chance to collaborate with her in the future. Let's see. Thank you to the flurry of volunteers behind me, the few, the proud, the Legato Pesante Tuba Quartet, for not only doing the footwork here, but over the course of the entire semester to prepare the music you're about to hear and putting up with my composition style. Let's see. Thank you to my wonderful family and friends who have supported me through what is undoubtedly the most challenging semester of my life. And thank you to my beautiful wife, who, despite our extra hard mode version of this year's events, has been there to encourage me to persist, work hard, and strive towards my dreams, even still. If I forgot to thank anybody, thanks. Let's see, they're about ready. So this next piece you're about to hear is a piece of my own creation called El Tuba Cabra. It is a piece written for Tuba Quartet, and it's about the titular character, a bandito named El Tuba Cabra, who steals tubas from the rich, gives them to the poor, and his experiences with valor, love, defeat, and triumph. Let's do this. Thank you.
Thank you.